Hello everyone, I'm Rajani. I'm a student of Central Queensland University, Sydney campus. As a part of our assignment of Australian Commercial Law, I'm doing this video. Today I'm going to talk about the most popular case of intent to create a legal relationship. I have analyzed the case using IRAC method. Now let's talk about the background of my case. I have chosen the case of Edward versus Skyways Limited. Talking about the case, the secretary of the board of Skyways was empowered in discussion with the British Airline Pilot Association to agree to payment to redundant EQ member of an ex gratia amount with regard to pension and superannuation. The company and association representatives met and agreed that payment would be made of an ex gratia amount with regard to the pension payment and the refund of contribution. The decision was published in the newsletter. One redundant pilot was told what his payment and refund would be. He received the refund, but then the company cancelled its decision to make the ex gratia payment. When he sought to recover it, it was told that there was no obligation to pay it. Here, in this case, the main issue is that was there a legally enforceable right to payment? Were legal relation intended by the agreement? Now, talking about the relevant law, according to the Australian law, there is no any law and there is no any legal rule for this case, so this cannot be enforceable in the court. Now, talking about the application, the company admits that a promise was made and that it intended to carry it out. The plaintiff acted on the belief that it would be fulfilled. The company says the promise and agreement had no legal effect because there was no intention to enter a legal relation. This case is similar to the case of Rose and Frank and Balfour that recognizes that an agreement may not give the rise to the legal right because this was not intended in the social relation of the case. Even regarding the business of years, the parties can show that it was their intention to make the agreement binding in honor only, and the court will respect that intention. Now, lastly, I have summarized some remedies for this case. As the subject of the agreement was commercial in the nature, and the presumption was that the parties intended to create legal relations, the onus was on the company to show that legal relations were not intended, and there was no evidence to show. Example, by the use of a clear words that the transaction was intended to be binding in honor only, there was therefore an enforceable contract, and the pilot was entitled to the ex gratia payment. This is all in this case. Thanks for watching video.